Long ago, on a night much like this, Tamanui Te Rā was setting in the sky. In the village, the day's harvest had been stored away in the pataka, and the families were all preparing to sleep. One night, while Te Marama, the moon, watched from the night sky, Rona stormed out of the Wharepuni after arguing about who should fill the taha.
Te Marama is a man.
I think she's a woman.
Well, it doesn't matter what you think. It matters what's true. You're still reading that juvenile book to her?
I think she likes it because it's got your name in it. I think it's her way of trying to get closer to you.
Well, what are we going to do about the water?
We could have a bottle of wine.
I'm freezing and I want a cup of tea.
Okay, jeez. There's a stream about 5 minutes away. I could go and get it after...
No, I'll do it. What could calm me down? I'm just like...
Yeah, I know. That's why we're here, babe. You know where the stream is?
Yep, got my torch and I got the map. Forget the water, and then you forget the batteries!
Ugh. Rona made her way along the path, guided by the lights of Te Marama.
Shit! Can't you shine a little brighter?
Rona was distracted by her anger. She stomped heavily on a path which she should have been treading carefully. At that moment, Te Marama hid herself behind the cloud, and Rona was plunged into the darkness.
Shit!
Rona cursed at Te Marama, blaming the moon for her own clumsiness.
You stupid moon! What's the big deal, huh? Of course I'm talking to you! Look what you made me do!
No kete he tūtua Pakihara. Kia tūpato rā kai hingara wā tūkui.
Great! You're just a moon! You're nothing! You're just a white spot in the sky! Pōkokohua!
Te Marama was angered by Rona's rudeness. She reached out and plucked Rona from the ground.
Yes, my love.
It's okay. Your mum's been under a lot of stress lately. But things will get better, I promise. Would you like me to sing you a waiata? E rona e, kei whea koe, anei ke, e piki nei, e heke nei, te marama kōpuwhio.